We've reconnected the earthing conductor just there because obviously we need all the parallel earth paths in order to do our prospective earth fault and short circuit current. So we're going to start off by doing our prospective earth fault current. I see you've set your instrument there to 2 lead high and you're over there. Is that on PE? Is that LPE?
LPE.
Yeah, okay, on the actual mega 1730. Okay, if you want to probe on. Okay. We're not expecting this necessarily to be a reading we use, and we'll explain that later on in the video when we go through doing between line and neutrals, and then we'll have a little chat at the end and a little rule of thumb we'll suggest. Yeah.
Okay, so get our good connection onto the earth bar there.
Yeah.
And again, it's on the 2 lead high automatic test.
Okay. So we're going to go through this, and we've got to remember these, but not necessarily worry
so
too much.
Okay. Phase one was 2.3.
Okay, that's 2,320 amps. Okay.
That's it. Yep. Phase two.
Okay, 2,130 amps. Okay.
And then phase three. And 2.1.
Okay, so we're going to go on now and do the similar test, but this time between the line conductors to the neutral, and then we'll have a little chat about this rule of thumb.
Is we're going to turn it over.
So that's now to LL and LN.
Yes.
And we're on 2 lead. Does it mean we now have to change our leads in the back of the instrument as well?
Yeah, so again, we're going to be using these two leads here. So in this case, we're just going to use the red and the black.
Okay, so yeah, that's a key point to mention because sometimes people change their leads around in there, don't they? Yeah. So we're going to now just be using our two leads.
Yeah, so again, we're just going to probe onto the neutral conductor.
Yep.
And then onto the line conductor. And again, you can see it's picked up
a voltage
there.
As we're testing there, and then we come back. It should come through a little quicker. It has. So that's 2,720 amps. Okay.
Again, that's phase one. So we'll make a note of that. We'll go on to phase two.
Okay. So that's 1,972. Yeah, 70 amps. Yeah, sorry, apologise. So that's 2,720 amps. Okay. So we suggested throughout that video, there is a rule of thumb when we're doing a three-phase supply. And we know at college, often you're working on single-phase installations. And when you get your AM2, AM2S, AM2E, it all can be a bit confusing. But we're going to solve that confusion now. Of all the readings we got, we look at the highest one, am I right in thinking, Matt, between our line and neutral?
Yeah.
And we do mathematically what with that before we record it?
So we simply, it's easy calculator, just double it.
Okay. Now, we're always going to take the highest reading and double it through and record it on our test paperwork. Because what could we have as a fault in a three-phase system?
The measurements we have took is if between sort of earth and phase and or neutral and phase. But the worst case would be if it was between phases.
Yeah, so in other words, a fault was between a couple of line conductors or three line conductors. We get the most amount of fault current flowing.
Yeah.
And therefore, we need to prove that our device can actually clear that fault.
Yeah.
Okay, so you'll be looking at the mains end and working out the prospective fault current of that device. But when you're recording it on your paperwork, you take your highest reading between your line conductor and neutral and double it through. Our reading was, I think, roughly 2.7.
2.7.
Someone will correct us slightly, but it's near enough 2.7. Yeah. And you double that, and your math suggests that's how many?
Just over five kiloamps. 5.4 kiloamps.
Thank you very much, Matthew. Yes, he's managed to get through on the math. So it's 5.4 kiloamps would be recorded on the test paperwork. Okay, and that's really important for AM2, AM2S, AM2E, that you double that number. And people have actually dropped, you know, I don't suggest failed, because you get minor marks as you go along. That's an easy one not to forget, isn't it?
And again, just to think about it, with the circuit breakers as well, they are rated at often 6 kiloamps or 10 kiloamps. So that does have an effect of the type of circuit breaker you're using, whether it's a 6 kiloamp or a 10 kiloamp.
Yeah, and we've looked at that in other video presentations as well. However, we're going to carry on a little bit further because it could be that your AM2 and AM2S gets developed and your test instrument actually allows you to carry out between line conductors and will give us that reading. So for this part of the video, we're going to carry on and see what the actual short circuit between live conductors is.
Yes.
So we've kept the instrument in the same position here, but we're actually now going to be testing between the two line conductors. Let's do that then, Matthew.
So again, this time it's important to use the this setter, the setting with this one and this one here.
Yep. Okay.
So again, it's just set on the 2 lead high.
Yep, exactly where we were before. And it did say, didn't we? We saw before it says L and L, doesn't it, down there?
Yeah. And so again, we just probe on to, so this time we're going to go between phase one and phase two. And you can see there it picks up the voltage.
And that's 3,280. Okay, we move across. So we're going to do
then we'll go between phase two and phase three.
Okay, yep. People are saying this is nowhere near the one we recorded. We'll just explain that a little bit in a moment. So that's 2790.
That's it. And then we'll go between phase one and phase three.
And that's 4,110. Now, the thinking behind that is obviously we've got a TNCS earthing system here. Yeah, we've got a neutral and earth connected together and all the rest of it. And we'll go into a bit more detail on that in a different video. We've just got to remember that rule of doubling through our readings that we suggested earlier. So thank you, Matt, for showing us that. And we believe that's key information done with your AM2, AM2S, etc. So the end of the video, remember to double through the reading that you got when you tested between a line conductor and neutral, the highest value, and record it as your prospective fault current. As the qualification maybe develops, it might be a case if they are allowing you actually to measure between two line conductors. And if that's the case, obviously you record the highest of those three readings we got there. Yeah. That wasn't exactly doubled through, was it?
It wasn't exactly, but it's...
Yeah, but it is a rule of thumb. And again, if you want more detail on that in the future, we'll produce a video that can help you understand why that is. As always, what we've got to say at this bit, mate, it's been a long time. What have we got to say?
Okay, I hope this video has been some help.
We do.